Let's just all stand to our feet tonight. We want Brother Barnhill to come and obey the Lord tonight. And let's just open our ears up spiritually and naturally. Don't let nothing distract you. And receive what the Lord has for us tonight. Amen. We're so glad for those of you that's here for the first time. And glad, want you to know you're welcome all the time. All of you. God bless you, Brother. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Father, we come to you, Lord, this afternoon. Jesus, thanking you for another day that you've given us, Lord, together, Lord, to fellowship with you and to fellowship with one another. Lord, you said that our fellowship be with the Father and the Son. Lord, and it's a spirit that we enjoy. I thank you for all my brothers that's here and my sisters. Lord, I appreciate my natural sisters, Lord, and my nephews, but Lord, I feel more at home here with this, my spiritual brothers and sisters. Lord, I guess one time when they come to you about your brothers and sisters, you told them, spun around and pointed to the people that had been with you and following you. No doubt in 12 said, these are my mothers and sisters and brothers. They that hear the word of God and do it. So we thank you for our brothers and sisters and all of our family, Lord, and a spiritual family. And we get to heaven, Lord. And you said in that resurrection, Lord, it won't even though we'll know one another as we're known, it won't be like it is here. Lord, and we just thank you for this gathering. Thank you for this time of appreciation, Lord. And we give honor to whom honor is due, Lord. Oh, Lord, I pray, Lord, that today that you would look down over these petitions, Lord. Lord, and help Jesus. Lord, you know what's needed in this, Lord, concerning, Lord, this one here. Lord, don't let it go unanswered. This needs healing, Lord, of cancer. Oh, God. Lord, I know you're able, more than able to heal. Lord, move in his foot and all this here, Jesus. God, make whole. You're the Lord. Lord, you said you're the Lord that healeth thee. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you would bless today all these, Lord, jobs and, Lord, situations, Lord. Don't let a one of them and do a quick work here in them, Lord. God, this one here wanting to, Lord, get in a little, Lord, in a fast, Lord. God, all of us need to do that, Jesus. And so I pray right now that you would, Lord, bless them, Lord, to get ready to, Lord, to get in a time after, Lord, this time, Lord, Lord, they just get so hungry for you, Lord. They just want to live in them closets and live in fasting, Lord, day or two a week, Lord. Lord, all often fasting, Paul said. Lord, it would be a day or two a week that we can fast, Lord. God, we pray tonight, Lord, that you would guide skillfully every course in every direction, Jesus. Lord, in everything that's done, by the holy name of Jesus, Lord, we ask it to be so. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's give the Lord a big old hand, praise. Let's go over and take somebody's hand and tell them Jesus is in the house.
Jesus.
They've been seated for a few moments. And I believe, and I know he is, you know. Somebody, I watched that movie, I don't get too much to watch TV, but years and years ago, that movie where Jesus, they said that was Peter's house. He tore that hole. Peter was a screaming. I guess if I went home, somebody's tearing a hole through my roof, I'd be doing a little holler myself. Wouldn't you? They're tearing that. And you know, that's pretty desperate when you get to Jesus bad enough to rip a hole in the roof. Man, I preached a message one time on how bad do you want to see him? I thought, Lord, one man wanted to see him bad enough, and this man was a popular man. You know, he was one of the chief of them. He wanted to see him bad enough to climb up in a tree. Now, that buddy, that's wanting to see Jesus, ain't I'm going to go down here and get me a, and I don't know what you call them here, but now, man, we call them gnat codes. Is that all right? Amen. remember me? Been a few years, ain't it?
Many years.
A few gray hairs. I ain't claiming none myself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just appreciate the Lord. We're back here getting me another nap because of over here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, I've been fell in love with this couple of hymns. All right. Thank you, Lord. Honeymooners. Ain't nothing wrong with that. How many of you know Jesus went to a marriage on the third day, didn't he? Hallelujah, man. He didn't want to see that marriage messed up. Because his mama kind of put him on the little spot, didn't she? Woman, what have I got to do with you? My, we ain't got here yet. Hallelujah. And she spun around, looked at him servant, said, whatever he tells you to do, do it. Man, it was about six water pots there containing two or three fur skins apiece and about 153 gallons, they say, somewhere in that neighborhood. And he said, go fill them up. Amen. Lord, how many of you know that's what we need to be doing, is filling these temples here up? Don't worry about the wine, just go fill them up with water. And they filled them things up and brought them back. And Jesus said, now bear them out to the governor of the feast. Man, they buried them things out. That governor feast tasted that water. He said, my Lord, we're men of well drunk. Men of well drunk. Then you give them that old bad wine. He said, y'all say the best till last, though, didn't you? How many of you believe God say the best revival to the last? I do. I believe right now that, man, what God's fixing to do is going to be greater than, you know, we talk about the Coe revivals and Allen revivals. I met one of his bodyguards years ago. Man, that done me more good. And to meet him, told me how he just had to watch him with Allen. Would come off that platform, pray all night long in that little orchestra. That inspired me. And Brother Brandon's revivals and all them, all that Zusa Street revivals. But yet I believe that this last move of God is going to be greater if you put all them in a bucket and then put this last move. I believe this last move is going to be greater than all them moves together. How many of you want to be part of it? Hallelujah. Raise your hand and say, Lord, make me part of it. Lord, I must. I tell you, I'm planning on being right smack dab in the middle of it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I appreciate it. Lady here, huh? Did you get out to the revival meeting this week? I didn't think I seen you out there. I sure missed you. That daughter of yours, where is she at? Tell her we appreciate her and love her. Miss her. Hallelujah. And God, Lord, just put a fire in her bones, Lord. Light her up. Jesus' name. And we ain't going to hold you too long. I was walking back there. I might have heard her stomach growl. Play something about that food. Makes people get hungry, don't it? But we want to feed you. Maybe for a few minutes here on some natural food tonight. And then we get in that, well, I guess we call this spiritual food first. And then we get in some of this good old home Georgia cooking. Hallelujah. And everything. But I just want to lift up Jesus a little bit tonight. Talk to him. And talk about him. I mean, you know, there ain't nothing else to talk about. You know, Paul said he was determined. He didn't want to know nothing. Nothing but Jesus Christ and the cross. I thought, Lord, make me that way. I was telling my wife all ago, I said, man, I wish I could pray the Lord's Prayer 1,000 times a day. But you know, that prayer about got everything you need. And our Father which art in heaven, hallowed. Well, you got to start off with giving that name a little praise. Amen. Thy kingdom come. How many of you know we sure need that kingdom?
Yes.
Thy will. How many of you want God's will to be done in your life?
Yes.
In earth. That's us. not on but in earth as it's done in up there. And I guarantee up there in that new earth, I mean that new heaven, ain't nothing done. It ain't the will of God. Amen. And that other, that devil got up there and kind of messed it up a little bit. Messed this earth up downhill a little bit. But boy, ain't you glad in that new heaven ain't going to be no messing up. Man, everything going to be perfect. Man, sometime I just wouldn't mind going. Hallelujah. That's right. But I know God got me down here, you know, for a little while longer, maybe. I don't know how long he's planning on. At times I'm thinking, Lord, I pluck my out. Look at something that ain't good or something, I pluck my out. You take me on out in now, but can't do that neither. Thank you, Lord, but God's good.
Yes.
And then he says, forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. Some of us ain't quite got there yet. I mean, you know, we need to start forgiving. And real love, it forgives. And ain't you glad God don't bring up your past? Bible said he takes them sins and throws them in where? Of what? Forgetfulness. As far as the east is from the west. And that means there ain't no end to it. No matter how far you get to the east, it's still going to be a west somewhere. Ain't that right? No matter how far you get to the west, there's still going to be an east somewhere. So he said, that's how far you, man, he don't, and he races them out of his mind. Man, if somebody does you wrong, you, every time you see them, you think about it. Talk about it. That's right, love, don't be bringing up the past. Lord, if God brought all my sorry dog ways up, I did. Lord, I never would. I'd be in a mess, wouldn't you? And then, man, lead us not into temptation. And God don't do it. Man, I tell you, man's tempted when he's drawn away of his own lust. But delivers from evil, for thine is the kingdom, and power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We're going to get in some scriptures, talk to us, and get on with this here. I want to go to the book of Matthew chapter 11 tonight. And main course is service. We know what it's for tonight. We, like I say, we do appreciate Sister Lawrence and the Ted and standing here trying to hold a torch. But I want to read one verse here in verse 28. And I might go ahead and read 29 and 30. It said here, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart. You shall find rest unto your souls. My yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Father, appreciate you, Lord. You know, Lord, my sufficiency is not of self, and without you, Jesus, ain't nothing going to be accomplished. Lord, and I just let myself and everybody else know that I'm just the vessel. And Lord, I'm praying that you'll use us tonight to say something, to inspire somebody, and let us cast our eyes a little bit farther on you, Jesus, Lord, and do what the scripture says. Oh, Father, to come unto you, Lord, and you give us rest. Jesus' name, amen. Now, that's what I want to share and talk to us here for just a few moments tonight. It's time for us to really, really, I'll tell you, this day we're living in, we need to anyway, come unto Jesus. You know, everybody goes to everything else, but we need to start going to Jesus. How many of you know that? That's what he said, come unto me, what? All ye, that's everybody. Like we said over in Acts 10, God ain't no respect of person. How many of you glad God don't love one person more than he loves another person? Man, the Bible said, you know, that it, you know, he was kind of partial to his own, but they didn't receive it. But then he gave the Holy Ghost to the Gentiles, you know, and it's now, for God so loved what?
World.
The whole world. That's right, everybody. God, you know, he loves everybody. And So he said, come unto me, all ye that are labored under the load of something that the enemy may be trying to oppress you with. You know, Jesus said, I've come to give you life. Didn't he say that? The devil comes to what? Steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I come to give you life and to give it to you more abundantly. Man, if we could just get this generation to turn to Jesus, to come unto him. You know, all through these examples in the Bible, you know, if you go back to Matthew's 8, the Bible said after Jesus had finished those five, six, and seven of Matthew's, I call them, you know, I met a man one time that he went to had a school, and they built their whole, this has been years ago, they built their whole schooling on Matthew 5, 6, and 7. I thought, Lord, boy, that's something, man. Man, I tell you, but you can't go, man, ain't nothing no hardly greater than that. What he teaches you to do everything, don't he? Blessed are the poor in spirit. Meek, ask, seek, now all that stuff. Tell us how to give. You know, all that kind of stuff. And that's just, you know, you just about build your life on them three chapters there. But the Bible said after that, that Jesus, there was a leper man. You know, we've been to India, we see them colonies of leprosy there. Lord, they have to set, I remember one city that we was in, and Brother Terrell was preaching a crusade there, and there was a colony of lepers, and they'd have to have a space probably as wide as this, you know, that far between them and the people. Because they said it was contagious. You know, and it was a curse. How many of you know that? And one time the Bible said right there in Matthew 8 that a leper man heard about Jesus. Man, I'm telling you, it's time for us to start talking about him everywhere we go, lifting him up. And he come down that hill to where Jesus was. Don't you look and hear what he said? He said, Lord, if you will. In other words, Lord, it's up to you. If you will, you can make me clean. Yes. How many of you know Jesus didn't have to think about it? Man, don't never let that devil tell you you're not worthy to be saved or be healed.
Amen.
Man, that devil's a liar. The Bible said he's a liar and the father of it.
Yes.
And you know what he done? He got his eyes, you know, leprosy being a curse, he got his eyes off of the curse. Man, never see yourself as under a curse. Never see yourself as the devil about to get you advantage of you. Man, the Bible said in over in Epistle 1 John 4 and 4 that greater is he that lives inside of you than he that lives in the world. Man, that devil, man, Jesus, right there in Matthew 10, give us power over what? All powers of the enemy. And said that what? Nothing shall by any means harm or hurt you. Man, it's time for us to start believing the Word of God more than we believe what our mind may tell us. You're not under no curse. And the man got his eyes off of the curse, got his eyes on Jesus. That's what we need to do right now. Hallelujah. Get our eyes off all this stuff. Get our eyes on Jesus. And he said, Lord, if you will, you can make me clean. And look at that, Jesus. Jesus didn't have to say, well, let me go pray about it. What do you do to receive this curse? You know, a lot of times people accuse you. And if people accuse you, Bible said the devil's the accuser of the... That means they are devil. That's what he said, didn't he? The devil's accuser of the brother. And he got his eyes off of the curse, got his eyes off what his forefathers done. Man, never confess while it runs in the family. Man, you're not under that curse of that family anymore. You under Jesus' blessing now. Hallelujah. Get over there, even in the natural, get over there and read Deuteronomy 28. I tell folks all the time, I call my hands, I got names for my hands, prosperity. And I do. I tell folks all the time, these is man, God told God's way, everywhere you put your foot, you're going to be blessed, didn't he? Everything you set your hands to is going to prosper. Hallelujah. It's time to take over and go into this land that I promised Moses. Hallelujah. 40 years ago. I'm telling you right now, folks, it's time for us to take, and I ain't talking about a natural land. All this stuff is good. Hallelujah. But I'm talking about a land flowing with spiritual milk and honey. Hallelujah. God knows how to drive them Amalekites and Hittites and Prittites and them seven nations away from us if he has to get them angels up there to get them a bunch of rocks and throw them down there and knock them in the head. That's what he done one time, didn't he? Got them a bunch of rocks, and I don't know if it was pieces of stars or how they got them, but they got them some pieces of rock, and they started throwing down there and killed, what was it, 158,000 of them? Hallelujah. Slew them. Hallelujah. Because they was God's enemy. Let me tell you something right now. The devil is your enemy, and God has given you power over him, and it's time for us to start acting like we got power. It's time for us to start, hallelujah, acting like that we're more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. I run around all the time looking behind me, and folks say, what are you doing? I say, I'm looking at Mr. Goodness, and I'm looking at Mr. Mercy. Hallelujah. Because they follow me, not just every now and then, but they follow me all the days of my life. All the days of my life. Goodness and mercy follows me. Man, I feel like running. I'm going to make 100. 99 and a half ain't going to do. We're going to attain what the rest of them didn't attain. Paul said, I didn't attain it. Well, let me tell you, I believe we're going to attain that place. I believe we come in. Hallelujah. He said, when he comes, we'll be what? Like him. For we'll what? See him as he is. Not in heaven up yonder, but we'll be like him down here on this earth. Hallelujah. Thomas said, Lord, show us the Father. It'll satisfy us. Thomas, hallelujah. Don't you know I've been with you and you don't know who I am? When you see me, you see the Father. Oh, hallelujah. He's coming to be glorified. I have glorified him both. And I'm going to glorify him again. Everybody thinks that's when he's coming. He's going to be glorified in what? In the saints. Hallelujah. Father, glorify me with the glory that I had with you before the foundation of the world. That's what I say sometimes. Father, glorify me with that glory that I had with you when I was preordained and predestined before the foundation of the world. You say, you crazy. Before Abraham was, I am. Oh, hallelujah. That's right. Jesus said, they took up stones to stone him. You ain't even 50 years old. What you talking about? Hallelujah. I was in that bush and spoke to Moses and told him to pull off his shoes. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Yes.
So what are you doing? I'm standing on holy ground.
Don't be embarrassed if socks have got a hole in it.
Now that'll be all right. They'll be holy socks.
Hallelujah. I'm standing on holy ground. Hallelujah. Everywhere you put your feet, foot, Joshua. Hallelujah. I'm going to bless you. Ain't no enemy going to be able to stand before you. Let me tell you what God's fixing to do. He's fixing to drive the devil. This world might be out there, but he ain't got nothing in me. Is that what Jesus said? He cometh, but he ain't got nothing in me. I'm free. Everybody say, I'm free. You'll know the truth, and the truth, you know what it's doing? It's making us free. Hallelujah. God's got some people that's thinking to stand up against the devil and tell him, Satan, get behind me. You don't know the things that be of God. Are the sons of God. Hallelujah. It does not yet appear what we shall. shall be. But we know that when we see him, hallelujah, I tell you what, I've already tasted of the powers of the world to come. Well, I'm a standing on holy ground. I'm a standing on holy ground. Who are you, Lord? Hallelujah. You know, the first thing God had to do was get Moses' attention. Hallelujah. That's what God's trying to do right now, is get our attention. Hallelujah. Moses turned aside. Hallelujah. He'd been out there for 40 years, smelling like a sheep. That's why God made him get them shoes off. They were dumb shoes. I believe God fixing to get somebody's attention. Yes. Hallelujah. God, Moses done tried it in the natural and it didn't work. He done slew that Egyptian. Hallelujah. Got two of the church buddies together. One of them that did his brother wrong, that's one that always, you know, most of the time want to throw the blame and do the talking. Will you kill me? You did that Egyptian yesterday. Bible said that that saying Moses fled. Went out there on the backside of the desert. Hallelujah, got married and thought, man, I'm all right now. I'm just going to take it easy. Some of you right now got ministries that God got ordained for you. And you think, no, I'm just going to be a simple man. You know what's fixing to happen? A fire is fixing to burn inside of you. Hallelujah. God ain't satisfied with you sitting around taking care of a few sheep. He's got people that need helping. People, oh my God, that need delivering. You don't know what you've been doing these years. When you've been, hallelujah, trying to fast a meal or two. Who did that put on that note wanting to do a little fasting? Hallelujah. Stand up. Stand up. Raise them hands. Right now, God, I drop a spirit of fasting in her. Oh, God, Lord, something that she gets in such a spirit, Lord, in a realm. God of the heavens, God, that you begin to show her angels. Angels begin to minister to her. Oh, somebody praise him. God's going to do it, sister. Hallelujah. Somebody praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know what? God. Before his army, he's fixing to sound the trumpet. Hallelujah. And he's going to scatter, hallelujah, not the people, but he's going to scatter the power. Everybody say the power. He's fixing to scatter the power of the holy people. Hallelujah. The holy people is going to have power. That power is fixing to be scattered all over America, Canada, Mexico. The holy see the power of God in a demonstration. Hallelujah. And you and I are going to be part of it. Well, I can just see Moses. That old stick in his hand, you know. Man, I got it made down here. Got myself a good looking wife. Got myself some youngins. I ain't got nothing to worry about. Got a good father-in-law. Get back up a little bit, yeah. He's a good one, boy. Lord, I must say. He's beat me with every stick that can be spiritually beaten with. He's called me every spiritual name in the book that can be called. Holy life, 40 years. Hallelujah. I invented that word stupid. Don't. Ain't got to make a sense. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. I always say, Lord, whom you love, you chasten. Lord, you must really love me pretty good. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. That's what he said to the church in Revelations over there. Hallelujah. Be zealous, therefore. Hallelujah. And what? Repent. Hallelujah. I love. I chasten people. You know what God's doing right now? God's putting some of you back on that potter's wheel. You got a few flaws, but when he gets through with you, hallelujah, them flaws is going to... Oh, stand up, Brother David. Hallelujah. God showed me he's fixing to do something in your life. Hallelujah. That's how even the people around you... Oh, I ain't no better to tell you. Hallelujah. Give him a praise. Say, God is getting ready. I said, God, he's getting ready to do something for his people. They think it to be a move. I don't care what the devil says. All the laws in the country ain't going to stop what God's doing. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said, ain't the devil big enough to stop what God's doing? Not fixing to do, but he's doing it right now. Yes. Hallelujah. He has, he does, and he's yet going to. Right now, he's the same. Yesterday, today, and forever, I'm the Lord, and I change not. Who they have by you? Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. I just see old Moses up there, walking around with that stick, looking. One day, looked up there and saw a bush on fire, being burning, but it wasn't being consumed. Probably next day, walked up there and thought, man, I thought that thing, I said it was yesterday, but it's still going. Ain't you glad God don't go out? Yes. Hallelujah. You know, down here, you burn something up, that's the end of it. But in the spirit, it ain't got no end to it. Now, sin got an end to it. I'm trying to get him to burn everything out of me that ain't right. But the God in me can't be burnt. Hallelujah. That's right. The spiritual God part, it can't be burnt out. I'll tell you what it does, it is a burner. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and what? And fire. Fan is in his hand. He's going to thoroughly purge his threshing floor and gather his wheat into the barn. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something right now. Hallelujah. You ain't no tare, but you are a wheat. Hallelujah. You're not a tare. Devil tries to tell you. You're a tare. He's a liar. You're a wheat. Hallelujah. I said you're a wheat. Hallelujah. You're a plant. And every plant that my Father have not planted. Hallelujah. He said in these last days he's going to send forth his angels and they're going to pluck up everything out of his kingdom. Let me tell you something. Hallelujah. But he don't pluck that weed up. You're big good ground. I can just imagine Moses after 3 or 4 days. The Bible said he turned aside. You know what turned aside means? Going from one thing to the other. Now, Lord, don't let me kill this service tonight. You know what we need to do? We need to turn aside from TV. Television. You can see them now. Everywhere you go, TV, television, they move the family out, put in a TV show. We need to turn aside from the TV and turn back to the Spirit, Word of God. Hallelujah. Meditate on it day and night. Read it until, hallelujah, you drop into sleep. Read it until, man, when you fall asleep, you wake up the next morning and it's laying on your chest. Oh, hallelujah. Eat his flesh and drink his blood. Hallelujah. Man, go to sleep down on your knees. And you, when you wake up, you're so cramped up, you got to get up and walk some. Get them charter horses and cramps out of you. Hallelujah. When's the last time you've done that? Hallelujah. Man, I tell you what, you won't wake up doing this. Oh, I got a good night's sleep last night. Hallelujah. We need to get something that gets us a little, that outer man. Hallelujah. A little cramped and a little stiff. But we need something to get that inner man. Hallelujah. Fire lit inside of him. How many of you know we need a fire lit inside of us? Hallelujah. I remember the kids. We lived in that house over there. And you know what a wood stove is, don't you? Huh? And I'd be traveling, you know, and I'd tell them boys, I say, now here's a, you know, the front door and the wood stove about like here, and there's the front door. Right there on the front door is a pile of wood this high. You know. I'd tell them boys, I said, now I'm leaving. I'll be back in 2-3 days, whatever. I said, all you got to do, see this here? Just open this up and get your sorry self out here. Open that front door. Get you a couple of pieces of wood and hold it in your hand and come in here and stick it in there and shut it back. That's all you got to do. And at about 4 o'clock in the morning, my wife called me and said, honey, it's freezing in here. Something wrong. I said, what are you talking about? Go check the wood heater. Went and checked the wood heater. There wasn't even enough red coals in there. Hallelujah. I had to get a man to come from 8 miles over there to light that thing up because them boys have messed it up. Hallelujah. You know why? Because they were too lazy to get a piece of wood. You know what's wrong with it? I got to run on this. The church is just too lazy to get out and pray a little bit. They too lazy to push that plate back. They too lazy. Hallelujah. All the way down is that little lady down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. And by that time you don't eat so much food that day, you snoring. Hallelujah. You don't want so much carnal stuff. Hallelujah. You ready for the logging? Hallelujah. But this is a time that we need to rise for the glory of the Lord. He's fixing to shine on his people. I said the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let God get your attention. Moses turned aside. Hallelujah. To see what was going on. And he got up there, and the closer he got, he began to feel something. I'm telling you, it won't be but a day or two of praying and fasting. You'll begin to feel a stir in the mulberry bush. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I can just see old Moses climbing up that mountain, getting up there, looking, saying, my Lord, that thing's on fire, but it ain't being consumed. What's going on? And then he got nearly about in the presence of it, and a voice come out, said, Moses, Moses, pull off your shoes. Some of us need to lay aside a few weights and sins that so easily beset us and get back. And I'm a running, going to make 100. Then I started watching the TV. Now I'm down to about 60. Lord, what's happened to me? We don't need to slow down. We need to get full steam ahead. Hallelujah. Wish I had that tablet. I'd sing that song for you tonight. Hallelujah. I remember that much of it. Thank you, Lord. One guy said he was a running and lost his prayer life, and now he couldn't even crawl. How many of you want to gain some ground?
Yes.
Man, don't you want to gain some ground?
Yes.
And that voice said, Moses, get rid of them shoes. You're standing in my presence. Get rid of them. Moses pulled his shoes off and went up there, and God said, Moses, I got something I want you to do. I want you to go down into Egypt and tell Pharaoh, let my people go.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You get to seeking God, and God will be sending you here and there. Hallelujah. Telling the devil, let my people go. You have no authority. Satan, you have no right. Hallelujah. You have no authority. This is God's property. Get away from it. Hallelujah. Let my people go. Moses said, who do I tell them? Send me. Tell them I am has sent you. Well, Lord, I can't go down there without something. What you got in your hand? A staff. Throw it down. He threw it down and began to crawl. He said, Lord, I need another sign. He said, stick your hand in your bosom. Pull it out. It was leprosy. Hallelujah. He said, if that ain't enough, hallelujah, throw some water down. Before it hit the ground, it turned into blood. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm going to make and convince old Pharaoh that I am and come down. And you know what God told Moses? He said, I've heard the cry of my people. God wants to hear the cry of you crying. Oh, that's what God's waiting on right now. God's waiting on the cry. The cry of my people has come up. The cry of my people has come up. Let God hear a cry. It won't be long before deliverance has come. Oh, hallelujah. God wants to do something for us, folks. He's ready for a move. I know he's ready. Man, I believe the hour's here. All of you that's been around, you've heard Brother Terrell. I know I've probably heard him 500 times. The brother back there even heard him way back yonder when he was running a sound system. We're either going to go in and take it now, or are we going into 40 years of darkness? Hallelujah. Let me tell you, I ain't going into no darkness. I don't want to see no darkness. I want to see a move of God. Hallelujah. I'm going to be like Joshua and Caleb. Some of you, I believe, going to be the same way of another spirit. You're not going to say we can't do it, but you're going to say we can do it. We can take the land. I don't care how big the enemy is. I don't care if I'm a grasshopper in his sight. I can take the land, because if God be for me, who can be against me? If God be on my side, 1,000 fall and 10,000, but not a hair of my head will perish. Hallelujah. Turn aside and look to Jesus. He's here tonight to help you. I want you to stand to your feet right now. Get them hands up and tell God, Lord, right now, help me to turn aside to you, Lord. Help me to turn aside to you, Lord. Come on, get them hands up. Lord, help me tonight, Lord. God, to turn aside. Lord, to turn aside. Oh, God, this night, Lord, help me to turn aside. Help me, Lord. Come on, ask God to get your attention back on him. Oh, God, I know you want to wake some of us up, Lord. God, you want to stir. Oh, God, some of us tonight, Lord. God, I'm asking you, Lord. God, right now, Lord, help us to turn our attention, Lord. God, upon you. Oh, God, help us to look not at this other stuff. Get our eyes off of this other, God, and turn to you. Come on, get them hands up one more time and say, Jesus, I'm ready to look to you. Lord, I'm ready to look to you. Lord, I'm ready to look to you in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I command it. Lord, I command it to be so. I command it to be so in the name of Jesus. Right quickly, I just feel like there's a couple of everybody in here. Oh, Brother Max, we will come up here and touch them with a little oil and over here. And I'm just going to touch and ask God to help you to turn aside. Is that all right? Make a line and come across here. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, everybody, we lay hands on. Lord, let it turn aside. Well, I've called and chosen you, my son, for this last day work. Turn to me, and I, the Lord, will work out your life, saith the Almighty. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Now loosen. Lord, loosen that hungerness, that first love back inside of her in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I loosen the Spirit of God. Lord, for these